the seeds that America has sown throughout its history, since its birth, are going to come back to America in a way that we're going to prosper.
That little dwarf in North Korea, I'm getting a little tired of him. I think I'm going to go and pay him a visit, says the Lord. You watch and see what I do.
Come on, come on.
And that will be a big sign that the man that I'm sending with a stone for the giant is emerging, says the Lord.
To the future of America's energy needs, we will find it, we will dream it, and we will build it. American energy will power our ships, our planes, and our cities. American hands will bend the steel and pour the concrete that brings this energy into our homes and that exports this incredible newfound energy all around the world. And American grit will ensure that what we dream and what we build will truly be second to none. We will be number one again all the way. Going to make America great again. Thank you. God bless you. And God bless America. Thank you. Thank you very much.
20 years ago, I coined the expression think big, and it's been a part of my life ever since. It's also come true. I became an even bigger success after I said it than I was before. And that's one reason I think it's an important way to think. It obviously works, and that's what I'm going to talk about today. What I said exactly in my first book, The Art of the Deal, is as follows. I like thinking big. I always have. To me, it's very simple. If you're going to be thinking anyway, you might as well think big. That book was a bestseller, and it's considered a business classic at this point. But I never thought those words would become bestsellers in their own right. It's an interesting point that I'm famous for two very short statements. Think big and you're fired. But let's stick to the first one for today. And I'd suggest strongly that you pay attention so that you won't have to hear the second one. Thinking big starts with the details and grows from there. Because I'm a builder, I'm very aware of the importance of having a good foundation. You can't take chances in construction. You can't be haphazard and say, well, maybe this will work, maybe it won't, so let's try it and find out. Because a lot of people will be at risk. I have to know if something will work or not. Every inch has to be accounted for. In other words, thinking big starts with being thorough. So number one, be thorough. Don't count on happenstance to get you anywhere, because it won't. Number two, get a momentum going and keep your momentum going. You have to have big ideas, but you've got to have the energy to get them done, which can sometimes take a long time. If you don't have momentum, you will not have what it takes to get the job done. Patience alone isn't enough. I have a lawyer friend who used to refer to me as the reverse tornado who builds everything in his path. I always like that because it implies a lot of energy and a lot of momentum. And that's exactly what it takes to get anything done. So keep your momentum going. Number three, stay focused. You have to stay focused. The minute you lose focus, you will also be losing your momentum. They go together and you will accomplish a lot more, even amazing things, if you make sure you keep these two things working together for you. I've seen very talented people literally go down the drain because they couldn't seem to keep their focus long enough to get anything done. In this day of multitasking, that can be a real challenge, but it's absolutely necessary. Ask yourself this question, what should I be thinking about right now? That simple question can restore your focus in no time at all. And your answer right now should be listening to Donald Trump. Number four, look at the solution, not the problem. This is very important if you ever want to learn to think big. And here's why. No matter what you do, you're bound to run into problems. It's just part of life, a part of business, a part of anything worth doing. If you let the problems get in your way, they'll become bigger than your idea was to begin with, and you will be a wipeout. No matter how bad things look, keep your focus on the solution, and you will be surprised how things can work out, and work out properly. One way I do this is to ask myself when confronting a possible problem, is this a blip or is this a catastrophe? A catastrophe is something like an earthquake, a tsunami, a war, and so forth, and a blip is everything else. Right away, you'll have the right perspective, and your equilibrium will be restored. So keep your focus on the solution. Number five, see opportunity for what it is, an opportunity. For example, why are you listening to me today? Curiosity, you like me, you don't like me, you want to learn, you have nothing else to do, you want to hear me tell you you're fired. I hope not, but whatever your reasons might be, they've brought you to a good place to get involved and to learn. And that's an opportunity right there. People think that because I'm rich and famous, that I know everything. I know a lot. But one thing I know is that I don't know everything. So I ask myself this question every day. What can I learn today that I didn't know before? And you know what? I learn something new every single day. That's a big reason for my success, and the same thing can apply to you. Take the time to see today as an opportunity, and you'll be surprised by what can come your way. Be open to new ideas, and you will be creating your own opportunities before too long.
All points alert, all points alert, 6.0 earthquake, 5.6 earthquake has just struck northwest of Yellowstone. Again, 5.8, 5.6 earthquake has just struck northwest of Yellowstone in Montana on the northwest edge of the Craton. Hang tight, folks. It's about to hit the fan here, so stay tuned.
Are you... Come into the train, led by a man who wants to break the chains. Establishment is terrified, they can't control his reign. Let's meet this year on the Trump train. Are you come into the train, where brave men called out for a wall built by crane. Media is terrified, they can't control his reign. Let's meet this year on the Trump train. Are you coming to the train, where brave men called out the fools who lead in vain. Lobbyists are terrified, they can't control our reign. Let's meet this year on the Trump train. Are you coming to the train? Wear a hat of hope, side by side with me. Make America great again, break the chains. Let's meet this year on the Trump train.
I don't know what that dream is that you have. I don't care how disappointing it might have been as you've been working toward that dream. That dream that you're holding in your mind, that it's possible. That some of you already know that it's hard. It's not easy. It's hard changing your life. That in the process of working on your dreams, you are going to incur a lot of disappointment, a lot of failure, a lot of pain. There are moments when you're going to doubt yourself and say, God, why is this happening to me? I'm just trying to take care of my children and my mother. I'm not trying to steal or rob from anybody. Why did this have to happen to me? For those of you that have experienced some hardships, don't give up on your dream. Their rough times are going to come, but they have not come to stay. They have come to pass.
Greatness is not this wonderful, esoteric, elusive, godlike feature that only the special among us will ever taste. You know, it's something that truly exists in all of us.
It's very important for you to believe that you are the one. Most people, they raise a family, they earn a living, and then they die. They stop growing, they stop working on themselves, they stop stretching, they stop pushing themselves. That a lot of people like to complain, but they don't want to do anything about their situation. And most people don't work on their dreams. Why? One is because of fear, the fear of failure. What if things don't work out? And the fear of success. What if they do and I can't handle it? These are not risk takers.
You spend so much time with other people. You spend so much time trying to get people to like you. You know other people more than you know yourself. You studied them. You know about them. You want to hang out like them. You want to be just like them. And you know what? You've invested so much time in them, you don't know who you are. I challenge you to spend time by yourself.
It's necessary that you get the losers out of your life if you want to live your dream. But people who are running toward their dreams, life has a special kind of meaning.
When you become the right person, what you do is you start separating yourself from other people. You begin to have a certain uniqueness. As long as you're following other people, as long as you're being a copycat, you will never ever be the best copycat in the world, but you will be the best you could be. I'm challenging you to define your value.
That everybody won't see it. That everybody won't join you. That everybody won't have the vision. It's necessary to know that. That you are an uncommon breed. It's necessary that you align yourself with people and attract people into your business who are hungry, people who are unstoppable and unreasonable, people who are refusing to leave life just as it is and who want more. The people that are living their dream of finding winners to attach themselves to. The people that are living their dreams are the people that know that if it's going to happen, it's up to them.
If you want to be more successful, if you want to have and do stuff you ain't never done before, number two, I'm asking you to invest in you. To invest in you.
Someone's opinion of you does not have to become your reality. That you don't have to go through life being a victim. And even though you face disappointments, you have to know within yourself that I can do this. Even if no one else sees it for me, I must see it for myself.
This is what I believe, and I'm willing to die for it, period.
No matter how bad it is, or how bad it gets, I'm going to make it.
I want to represent an idea. I want to represent possibilities.
And some of you right now, you want to be, you know what I'm saying, you want to go to the next level. I want to counsel, you know, I want to be an engineer, I want to be a doctor. Listen to me, you can't get to that level. You can't get to the level economically where you want to be until you start investing in your mind. You're not reading books. I'm challenging y'all to go to conferences. I dare you to invest time. I dare you to be alone. I dare you to spend an hour getting to know yourself. When you become who you are, when you become the person that you were created to be, designed to be who you were designed to be, when you become an individual, what you do is you take yourself and you start separating yourself from other people. I tell you to get to a place where people don't like you, but don't even bother you no more. Why? Because you're not concerned with trying to make them happy, because you're trying to blow up. You're trying to get to the next level. I need you to invest in your mind. Invest in your mind. If you still talk about your dream, if you still talk about your goal, but you have not done anything, just take the first step.
That you can make your parents proud, you can make your school proud, you can touch millions of people's lives, and the world will never be the same again because you came this way. Don't let nobody steal your dream. After we face a rejection and a no, or we have a meeting and no one shows up, or somebody say, you can count on me, and they don't come through. What if we have that kind of attitude? The car's repossessed. Nobody believes in you. You've lost again and again and again. The lights are cut off, but you're still looking at your dream, reviewing it every day, and say to yourself, it's not over until I win. You can live your dream.
In this life, there's no surrender, and there's nothing left for us to do. Find the strength to see this through.
tell you something you already know. The world ain't all sunshine and rainbows. It's a very mean and nasty place, and I don't care how tough you are, it will beat you to your knees and keep you there permanently if you let it. You, me, or nobody is gonna hit as hard as life. But it ain't about how hard you hit. It's about how hard you can get hit and keep moving forward. How much you can take and keep moving forward. That's how winning is done.
You have to believe that something different can happen. He who says he can and he who says he can't are both usually right.
That most of you say you want to be successful, but you don't want it bad. You just kind of want it. You don't want it badder than you want to party. You don't want it as much as you want to be cool. Most of you don't want success as much as you want to sleep.
Our deepest fear is not that we are inadequate. Our deepest fear is that we are powerful beyond measure. It is our light, not our darkness, that most frightens us.
Said to the kid, it ain't about how hard you hit, it's about how hard you can get hit and keep moving forward. How much you can take and keep moving forward.
Or we can fight our way back into the light. We can climb out of hell. 1 inch at a time.
To be able at any moment to sacrifice what you are for what you will become.
I'm gonna show you how great I am.
The 17th chapter of St. Luke, it is written, the kingdom of God is within man, not one man nor a group of men, but in all men, in you. You, the people, have the power to create machines, the power to create happiness. You, the people, have the power to make this life free and beautiful, to make this life a wonderful adventure.
Now, what are you gonna do?
Because limits, like fears, are often just an illusion.